Hi guys, my name's Nick Jennison, and today we're having a look at the PRS Sonzera 20 amp. It's a 20 watt 1x12 combo from the good folks of Paul Reed Smith. Two channels, clean and dirty, although we'll get onto what the dirty can do clean-wise a little bit later on. We've already had a little bit of a look at its bigger brother, the Sonzera 50, in the past. This is essentially a lower wattage, slightly sweeter, less bold version of the same thing. Now, in the intro, you heard me wailing away on this Paul Reed Smith McCarty soap bar using these P90 pickups. We're going to do a similar sort of thing with some humbuckers for you right now. So now that we've explored the more violent end of the drive channel, we've set up a loop on our TC flashback using the split bridge humbucker on the red guitar from just a second ago. We're going to fire that up and I'm going to explore the controls in the drive channel and see what that does. We should, using the drive and level controls, be able to coax an alternate clean sound out of this, which might be quite interesting. And we're also going to play with this lead, or rather gain bright switch down there, and see what that does. Let's fire that up now. And now we've set up a different loop to explore the clean channel, this time using the split neck humbucker. Let's do the same thing over here on the clean and see how that sounds. So as you can no doubt hear, both channels are capable of a great deal of tonal variety despite the relatively simple control layout. One thing to be aware of is that unlike the 50, there is a global presence and reverb control as opposed to having individual controls per channel. Shouldn't cause you too much of an issue though, I wouldn't imagine. Now sticking with the clean channel for a moment, we're going to explore this with a couple of pedals. We have an orange fur coat fuzz on the floor and we also have an MI Audio Super Crunch Box version 2, which is an amp in a box type pedal. We're going to try those into the clean channel, and we'll also try boosting the gain channel with a TS-type pedal. In this case, it's a Red Witch Scarlet Overdrive. Let's begin with the Super Crunch Box, then we'll do the fuzz, then we'll boost the gain channel.
Yeah.
And next up, we've got the Fur Coat Fuzz. And now we're back on the drive channel. We're going to try it with a moderate gain setting, and then we'll engage our TS style boost about halfway through. Let's see how that sounds. So as you can hear, the rather warm-voiced clean channel takes pedals beautifully well, and if the drive channel is a little too fat for your tastes, you can always tighten it up with a mid-centric overdrive pedal. So lots of versatility there with just a few little stomp boxes on the floor. Of course, you don't need any of that stuff because the amp sounds great all on its lonesome. There is a series effects loop around the back if you want to connect your delay and reverb or whatever kind of pedals in the effects return. Sounds great that way too, but you all know what that sounds like. I don't want to explore that today. And of course, there is a foot switch for the reverb and the channel switching, which is super nice. Anyway, guys, I'm going to leave that there. This is the Paul Reed Smith Sonzera 20. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and I will see you next time.